Management of hyponatremia is a significant challenge because therein lies a need to balance between rapid correction so as to avoid the devastating effect of hyponatremia while ensuring that there is no sudden rise in the level of sodium, particularly in chronic cases, which could have resulted in the development of central pontine myelinolysis. So therefore, one needs to really tread the path of balance to achieve a good outcome in a child with hyponatremia. The key principles are that emergent treatment is only indicated in children with acute severe manifestations like altered sensorium, impending coning, seizures, while in all other cases, one can manage with reasonable amount of fluid management. Therefore, the rate of correction because of the risk of hypernatremic problems which are happening because of a lot of fluctuations should be restricted to be less than 12 millimoles per liter per day in somebody who has an acute severe hyponatremia, and this should include the initial correction as well. In moderate cases, one can increase by around 6 to 9 millimoles per liter per day, but definitely in chronic cases, there is a need to for a specific caution, and therefore correction should not be more than 6 millimoles per liter per day. This rate is extremely important to adhere, otherwise there is a high risk of developing osmotic disequilibrium syndrome, which may manifest quite many days later also. One should also think of the underlying condition, in that for SIADH and fluid overload, fluid restriction is what is required. For hypovolemia, normal saline treatment is recommended in the initial phase. Overall, oral correction is preferred wherever possible, and usually the use of around 70 to 100 nanomoles millimoles per liter concentration of sodium along with 120 to 140% maintenance is enough. So the management of hyponatremia depends upon the symptoms. If there are acute severe symptoms, an initial bolus of 3 to 5 ml per kg of 3% sodium chloride in a 20 minute period is given. This may be followed by 3% sodium chloride infusion in severe cases. The aim of this acute correction is only to correct the symptoms, and it should be followed by gradual reduction, in that the overall 24 hour fall should not exceed 12 millimoles per liter per day. In acute moderate cases, no bolus is required, while we can start off with fluids with an aim of rise which is less than 6 to 9 millimoles per liter per day. While in chronic cases, acute treatment is absolutely contraindicated and rise should be less than 6 millimoles per liter per day. Hyponatremic dehydration is the most common situation, particularly in the setting of diarrhea, which is encountered. And fluid calculation becomes extremely important and complicated in this setting because we are dealing with three components of the maintenance, the deficit, which will be both in the form of hyponatremic sodium deficit and isotonic sodium deficit, as well as ongoing losses. So the first step is to calculate the fluid deficit according to the level of dehydration. And after we have done that, we can actually look at the effective blood volume in the current situation, which will basically be the normal blood volume, which is 0.6 into weight minus the deficit, which has been noted in this case. After this, one needs to calculate the amount of hyponatremic sodium deficit, which is calculated by the current effective body water into 135 minus sodium, and that is a very important parameter to really correct. We also need to correct for the isotonic sodium deficit, which is basically calculated based upon the fluid deficit in liters and multiplying it by around 140 in this situation. One also needs to consider the maintenance using the standard fluid guidelines and a sodium requirement of around 2 to 4 millimoles per kg per day. This correction is then planned over a 48 hour period, and one needs to consider the amount of bolus fluid and sodium that was given along with that bolus. Finally, one needs to calculate the fluid in terms of volume and tonicity, and whatever the calculation is, one needs to be very careful about close monitoring to avoid the rate of correction if there is a rapid rise, and sometimes relowering is required in somebody who has an acute symptomatic hyponatremia. So to illustrate the whole example, we have a 2-year-old girl, 12 kilograms with 10% dehydration and a serum sodium level of 120 millimoles per liter. Now, in this case, the first step is to calculate the fluid deficit, which happens to be 10%. So, 10% is 100 ml per kg into 12, it's 1.2 liters. So, now in this case, the current effective blood volume would be 0.6 into 12, which was the pre-treatment blood volume, minus 1.2, which is the deficit, and this comes to be 6 liters. So, the hyponatremic sodium deficit would be 6 into 135 minus 120, which is 90 millimoles per liter. So, this is the extra amount of sodium that we have to give above and beyond the isotonic correction. The isotonic deficit will be 1.2 into 140, which is 168 millimoles per liter. So, instead of just giving this 168 millimoles per liter, which would have been required for somebody who had presented with a eunatremic dehydration, we have to give an extra 90 millimoles per liter over a 48-hour period to ensure a reasonable rise of sodium. We need to calculate the maintenance for 2 days, which happens to be 2200 ml. And we have to calculate the sodium, which comes to 73 millimoles per liter. Now, this child also received a correction of 20 ml per kg of sodium chloride, which was 240 ml and which contained 36 millimoles per liter of sodium. So, now in net over the next 48 hours, we have to give them the maintenance, which is 2200 ml plus the fluid deficit, which is 1200 ml minus 240 ml, which has already been given, and this happens to be 3160 ml. We also have to give them the maintenance sodium, which is 73, plus 90 of the hyponatremic sodium deficit and 132 of the remaining isotonic sodium deficit, which turns out to be 295 millimoles. So ultimately, if we calculate, if we give somewhere around 90 millimoles per liter of sodium at 65 ml per hour, that will be sufficient in terms of the correction. So we'll go on to some cases in which the treatment had some issues. So this was a 9-year-old girl with chronic liver disease with a sodium of 115, anasarca, drowsiness, and somebody thought that this drowsiness is because of hyponatremia, and 3% saline was given and the patient became comatose and areflexic. So this obviously is the wrong approach to management, because this is a osmotic disequilibrium syndrome because of rapid changes in the sodium concentration. This could have been avoided because this is a chronic case. There is no need for any acute treatment. So in a nutshell, in individuals who have chronic hyponatremia, it's best to actually avoid the use of 3% saline. 18-year-old girl with acute intermittent porphyria presented with sodium of 125, normal potassium, had some headache, no vomiting or seizures. So this is a setting in which we are dealing with an acute moderate hyponatremia, and therefore the bolus should be avoided and fluid restriction may be considered in this setting. 10-year-old boy with 30 kilograms head injury presented with seizures and isochoria. Low sodium, and we are seeing the sodium is not as low as compared to other situations, but here, because of acute hyponatremia, there are seizures, there's high urinary sodium, so this is a cerebral salt wasting state. So this is an acute severe stage in which 3% saline was given, with which seizures were controlled and subsequently gradual correction was done. Specific management of hyponatremia depends upon the cause. So in fluid overload, correcting of the cause, fluid restriction, and SIADH fluid restriction is important. V2 receptor antagonists have not been studied in children effectively, and even in adults are not recommended in the acute correction of hyponatremia because they can cause rapid fall in the sodium levels, which may not be desirable. Adrenal insufficiency and aldosterone deficiency can be treated with hydrocortisone, fludrocortisone, or fludrocortisone alone. Pseudohypoaldosteronism and Bartter's are extremely challenging condition and require treatment with sodium chloride, furosemide, and the use of indomethacin and amiloride respectively. So once the diagnosis is made, the main issue is to correct the acute cause, look for the long-term cause, and appropriate management and referral should be done in these circumstances.